Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today I have my August melting basket. I wasn't sure if I was gonna get this video up in time or soon or whenever. Thank you so much to everybody on my previous video who congratulated me on getting married. The ceremony was beautiful. We ended up having to change all of our plans because of COVID. So it became like a backyard celebration, and truly I wouldn't have changed anything about it. So it turned out perfect, and it was like planned in 5 weeks basically. So it was a little bit last minute, but it really came together. So thank you so much to everybody who commented. Now I have a bunch of scents that for August I really wanted to do, like some more of my fruity scents because it is pretty still warm out. But I feel like I'm transitioning a little bit to not like blatantly fall scents, but I did try to pick out like a couple more bakery scents than I had in the past few months. But yeah, we'll see. So this is my giant bag. Let's go through them. The first one is Carnival from Hayden Row. This is what it looks like. It was part of her layered restock, so it's really pretty. And I think this one has, it's pretty different than some of the other Carnival scents I've seen. This one does not have like kettle corn or anything. I hate kettle corn scent notes. I don't like them at all. But this one has, I think, caramel apple, maybe cotton candy and waffle cone. I could be wrong, but we've got that one. It's really good. It reminds me of Cider Lane. From Rose Girls, strawberry, raspberry, guava, and blackberry Kool-Aid. From VCS, I have the grapefruit diet, which is just juicy, sweet grapefruit. This is from her Etsy shop. Also from VCS, I have Princess of Monaco. So, lemon curd swirled with gooey marshmallows. That one's lovely. I have one piece left of lime cotton candy from Hayden Row. I want to like pull that out and just finish it. In fact, that's exactly what I'm going to do. Also from Rose Girls, jumping on sweet lemon clouds. These are so pretty. I'm so excited to take melting pictures of that wax pool. I did not finish Candy Panda Tea and Cakes from last month, so I have that still in my basket. And same with Rose Girls Game Over. This one's better actually than I thought it was gonna be. It's good on cold, but when I warmed it up, I was blown away. It's so good. I've got this chunk of pineapple upside down sugar cookies from Rose Girls. I might actually cut this chunk into two pieces because it's pretty darn big. I have a couple muffins from Rose Girls. So strawberry pineapple taffy. I'm trying not to hoard like my Rose Girls muffins anymore. I feel like when I get them, I like don't want to use them, which is ridiculous, but I'm trying to do better with that. I've got Puppy Love from Rose Girls. I don't actually love this one because it has Love Spell in it, and I don't like Love Spell, but I'll see how it is, and if I don't love it, I'll probably pass it on to somebody else. Tan Lines from Rose Girls. Now, this one breaks my heart to use because it's so good. Oh my god. I think it's like orange and sunscreen, perhaps. It's so nice and summery, but I figure if I don't use it now, I'm not going to use it until next summer, so I don't want it to sit in my collection for that long. Strawberry raspberry ginger ale. I thought that would be a really nice refreshing summer scent as well. And raspberry cotton candy ice cream cake. I think that's it from Rose Girls. But I have quite a variety of other vendors in here as well. From Rainbow Melts, sun-drenched apricot rose. I just finished one of these, I think in July actually, and it was really nice. This one she actually sent as like a little thank you when I ordered my customs. I know my customs came a little bit late, which I didn't mind. But I don't know if this was like sent as a thank you because the customs were late or whatever, but either way, it's extremely generous to send that as an extra. From Rainbow Mouse as well, Black and Blue, which is blackberry jam and blueberry cobbler. That one is so good. From L3, strawberry guava. I know that in my most recent L3 order, I don't remember if I posted that video yet, but I got that as an extra in the order as well. So again, very generous, just like this one from Rainbow Mouse, extremely generous to send a shape this big as an extra. From VCS, Nelly's Sugar Spun Bubble Suds. So fresh laundry blended with sweet spun sugar, fluffy marshmallows, acai berries, and satin type. That one's beautiful. VCS Tropical Berry Sunset, coconut cream ice cream swirled with raspberry guava and fresh raspberry puree. I'm excited this one. I don't know if you can tell, but it's like sparkly. I don't mind glitter on my wax. I find that I'm able to get it out of my warmer pretty easily, but I know a lot of people don't love it. Hayden Row Shorts and Sweater. I've been really excited to melt this one. It's so cozy. I thought that this would be really nice for August, because, you know, like, I don't know, when it gets like transitions from summer to fall, you might wear shorts and a sweater. And it's just a little bit different than all the other fruity scents that I'm melting. From Hayden Row, I have Margarita. Beautiful margarita scent. It's super vibrant and super limey. And then from Teddy Bee's, I have Milk and Cookies, which is creamy vanilla, powdered sugar, sweet milk, and buttery cookie dough. Now the rest of everything in here is clamshells. So, Zape, I have Beach Bound, one little piece left that's going on the side with lime cotton candy to finish that one up. It breaks my heart to finish that because it's so good. It really smells just like a pure beachy goodness. So, but again, like, I don't want to save it past summer because I don't want to save one cube of it for next summer. Like, there's no point. So I'm going to use that one up. I'm going to enjoy it. Also from Zape, I have Lavender Soda. This one's so good. It's fresh lavender and citrus fizz. Oh, I didn't realize that. The scent notes are on this. Sunshine, tan lines, and beach vibes. That's exactly what I get from it. From The Bathing Garden, Miss Melanie. I forget what this is, like, what the exact notes are on this. But it's like, it's a melon scent, so it's like watermelon and honeydew perhaps. I think that those are in there. That's what it smells like, at least to me. Southbound Vintage Coffee Shop, rich roasted coffee and sweet vanilla beans. Southbound Hot Mess, grapefruit, lemon, mandarin, green tomato leaf, jasmine, eucalyptus, and musk. Oh, this one's so good. I get the green tomato leaf. It's so pretty. I get the green tomato leaf. I get like the lemon and the grapefruit. It's so good. I have a couple from Sassy Wax Melts. These are all customs that I made. So pineapples, butter pecan shortbread, and French vanilla. When I first got my Sassy Wax Melts order, I mean, it smells good, but I don't know, I didn't feel like the notes like blended super well together. But now that they've sat for a little bit, oh my gosh, they're like really amazing. So I'm really excited to try these a little bit more. Ice Cream Parlor, this is just one of her single scent oils, but I really wanted to try that one. It smells so good. Oh, I want to show you. It's adorable. And it smells super sweet and creamy, like an ice cream shop. It's so good. And then cotton candy, funnel cake, and vanilla sugar waffle cone. Oh my god, this one smells so good. It's totally transformed. There's a really cute butterfly on it. I don't even know what I'm getting out of this, but it smells amazing. So I'm really excited to warm that one. Let's see, we've got from Goose Creek, Sugar Donut. I'm really excited for that one too. And then the rest are all from Super Tarts. I feel like I'm on Super Tarts overload lately. I've placed a couple of fairly big orders from her recently. So I'm trying to get through some of my stash before those come. Or actually some have come and I'm trying to make room now. I have The Time Has Come, so Ocean Breeze, Blue Hawaiian Daiquiri, and Agave Sea Salt. I did use one piece of this in July, and it smells so good. I really get a nice balance between the Ocean Breeze and the Blue Hawaiian Daiquiri. Kryptonite is Key Lime, Coconut, and Suntan Lotion. This one's amazing too. I had this one in my July melting mask, but I just couldn't bring myself to melt it just yet because it's just so good and I don't want it to be over. But it reminds me of like being at the shore. So as soon as I smelled it, it was like a very nostalgic scent for me. I think it was the suntan lotion. I don't even know what it was about it, but it smells amazing. I'm really excited to use that one, but I'm not excited to finish it and not have it anymore. The Omen. Red Apple, Vanilla Bean, and Ocean Breeze. I thought this was a nice one for August as well because I feel like the Ocean Breeze and the apple is a nice transition from summer to fall. Iron Islands, which is Dune Grass, Sea Salt, and Teakwood. Really nice summery scent. Garden Hoe, which is Cherry Tomatoes, Red Apple, Green Vine Leaves, and Citron. So this one's interesting. I find that it almost has like a spicy note to it. It's kind of unusual, but I'm excited to warm it. And that's another one where I'm like, if I don't use this now, I don't really want to use it like in the fall or the winter. So better do it now. Pond, which is Jaws. So sea salt, ozone, seagrass, plum, and pear. Mixed with laundry. That one's amazing. Bloody Face. So Blood Orange, Rain, and Pink Sugar. Jackal, which is blackberry jam, zucchini bread, and toasted mallow. Toasted marshmallow. A lot of people love this scent. Like, it's a fan favorite. But I don't love it. I don't know. When I first got it, I really disliked it, actually. I hated it. I warmed it and it wasn't as bad, and smelling it right now after it cured, I guess, a little bit, I kind of like it. Like, I'm not gonna dread melting it, but when I first got it, I was like, why do people enjoy this scent? Lizzie, which is peach, magnolia, pear, jasmine, white amber, and grapefruit. This is a lovely peach floral sweet scent. Beauty and the Beast, which is blackberry and magically delicious. This is another one that like I'm dreading using because it's just so good, but I got this like on Wax Wednesday, and I know that Super Tarts, like the clamshell starts to like corrode after about a year, I've noticed, for me. So we're like gonna come up on a year fairly soon, I think, if I don't use this within the next couple months. I mean, I think there's like a little bit more time, but I mean, well, I'd rather just use it now than risk it going bad. Smallville, which is sweet berries, hot cakes, cornbread, and sponge sugar. This one I just got in a recent haul. It smells really nice. I really get a lot of the berry, so that felt like a nice August kind of summery scent too. And then finally, Ron, which is sweetened cereal, marshmallows, sugary milk, and orange sherbet. I thought I pulled another one out. I thought I pulled Harry out to go with this because I was like, oh, Harry and Ron. I guess I didn't though, because I have no idea where it is. Anyway, that is my August melting basket. I don't know, we'll see. In July, I really didn't do as well on my basket as I was hoping I would. I was quite ambitious with what I pulled out for myself. So I kind of went a little bit easier this month, and I figured I could always pull out more if we get halfway through the month and I realize like I'm flying through everything. So keep you guys posted. Of course, I will come back at the end of the month with my warm reviews on everything that I've used up. But for now, that is all. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you have a great day. Bye.